If you haven't seen an animal flying in slow-mo, you haven't lived. To see the detail and the elegance that they can turn, that they can maneuver, that they can avoid obstacles, that they can recover when you perturb them, it's just unbelievable. And if we can learn something from that when we make engineered vehicles, then we've done a good job.
We study the way bats fly in nature. We look at how the bats generate the forces of flight with their wings. We understand those forces and apply that to the design of human-engineered vehicles.
Technological advances are constantly increasing human potential for developing very small things. For the U.S. Air Force, this means evolutionary designs in future air vehicles, providing warfighters with tools that enhance situational awareness and the capacity to engage rapidly, precisely, and with minimal collateral damage. When it comes to improving flight mechanics in these vehicles, what better place to look for inspiration than bats, birds, or bugs? These natural flyers have been perfecting their flight techniques for millions of years.
If we can start to understand why insects have certain features in their wings, then we can start to not only answer questions about, for example, structure, function, relationships in nature, but start to use that to design better micro air vehicles for a variety of different missions.
What we're trying to do is just to understand the basic physics associated with just a simple motion like this. And that's kind of the big thing right now, is how do we control these little bug-sized robots and get them, or bird-sized robots, and get them to land where we want them to and to be precise. And so it's all about understanding that flow and then applying it to a controls-type world.
Historically, the only way to address the aerodynamic stress on aircraft during high-speed flight was to use rigid materials like titanium or aluminum. Today's engineers are using nature to learn how to develop and build structures from flexible materials.
Bats are very flexible. Their wings are very flexible and compliant. And the aerodynamics of compliant structures is really interesting and has not been explored very much. For the first time, we can really understand how animals fly in high detail, high resolution detail, and what the fluid motion is associated with that.
Researchers at AFRL's Air Vehicles Directorate, in collaboration with the wind tunnel work at Brown University, have also been working on high fidelity simulations of flexible wings.
Part of the work that we have done, sponsored by AFOSR and the STAR team, is develop very high accurate schemes that allow us to actually try to simulate the flow structure for a broad range of systems. We essentially took techniques that were very in academia, numerical techniques, mathematical techniques, and were able to put all these elements together in a way that provided the code that actually worked and is robust enough to use.
Just as biological studies and computer simulations are key contributors to the study of flight mechanics, so is the ability to build and test true-scale models of these vehicles. Using energized materials and folding techniques from origami, Professor Robert Wood is making significant inroads in this field.
Our lab is involved with a number of different topics in the creation of robotic insects. We are now designing a suite of experiments where we are going to manufacture many different wing types, shapes, stiffnesses, etc. When doing this at the scale with features that are very similar to actual insects, we make no assumptions. Whatever we're reading is the true phenomenon, and that's what we really like about this program and about this approach.
Understanding the details of biological flight mechanics has led to interesting applications for urban warfare. On the horizon are precision effects for small adaptable munitions and innovations for the greater air and sea battle domain. Learn more about U.S. Air Force-funded air vehicles projects by visiting our websites, www.afrl.af.mil and www.afosr.af.mil. Like us on Facebook, watch us on YouTube, or follow us on Twitter.